meal times can be fun family time as well. Meal times can be fun math time as well. How? Well, yes, I'll tell you. Suppose you have pizzas on for dinner. Now, how do you always ask your child if each one of your family member is eating two slices of pizza, how many slices of pizzas is required in all? Now, how do I say? Well, give them a bowl of beans and ask them to count it. Well, I say, Papa needs two. Here I remove for Papa. Mama needs two. I remove another color for Mama. A lovely card game. You can have any number of cards, any numbers you can write down, and you can ask them questions. So suppose if I say number which is formed by two lines, what do you think would be the answer? Is it going to be 11 or is it going to be 7? I think both. So when you ask your child, ask them to place that colorful dice on the number that they think is the correct answer, and you move forward. So the more you get more answers correctly and you have your dice on that, the person wins. So another card and dice lovely game would be, you can pick a card, you can ask your child to pick a card. In this case, my target number would be 7. I take 3 dice at a time, I roll them and come close to 7. My target number is 7 here. So I have 4, I have 3 and I have 1. Now how do I get it? 4 plus 3 will give me 7. Now what do I do with this one? Should I add, subtract, multiply or divide? Well, I don't have to add or subtract compulsorily. I can always multiply. I can always say 4 plus 3 is 7 multiplied by 1 is 7. So I get a perfect number. If a child is only doing addition or subtraction, no worries. You can always teach them 4 plus 3 plus 1 is 8, which is closer to 7. Or you can subtract it.
For more recipes, conversation, DIYs for kids, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss a video from kidsstoppress.com.